This Tiny Teach will discuss antibiotic resistance. In 2012, 93 bacterial species were discovered in a cave in New Mexico, which had been cut off from the surface for millions of years. Most of these species were found to have resistance to multiple antibiotics. How do bacteria become resistant to multiple antibiotics when they're cut off from everything for millions of years? One way that bacteria can acquire resistance is through spontaneous mutation. The chance that such a mutation will be advantageous is minimal. The chance that it will confer resistance to an antibiotic is even lower. Despite that, given the large number of bacteria in a population and the constant rate of mutation, mutations like this do occur. Another way that bacteria can acquire resistance is through acquisition of genes via conjugation, transformation, or transduction. Once bacteria have acquired resistance, they resist antibiotics by 1. Inactivating drugs by producing enzymes that permanently alter drug structure. Beta-lactamases, for example, break the beta-lactam ring of penicillins and cephalosporins, rendering the drugs inactive. 2. The resistance of some bacteria is due to preventing the drug from entering the bacterium and acting on its target. The outer membrane of gram-negative bacteria blocks some antibiotics that target peptidoglycan synthesis. 3. Some bacteria pump a drug out before it can even act. Many bacteria have multiple drug-resistant pumps that actively transport drugs out of the bacterium. These pumps can expel many different types of antimicrobial drugs, detergents, and other toxic chemicals. 4. Some bacteria resist antibiotics by altering the target sites of the drug. Bacteria alter their peptidoglycan or ribosome slightly so the drugs can't bind. And 5, an affected metabolic pathway is shut down or an alternative pathway is used. Bacteria, for example, can deviate from their usual pattern of folic acid synthesis.